I'm so tired of watching individuals explain buying versus renting completely wrong. You're gonna wanna stay and watch this video because I'm actually going to teach you guys the true real way to evaluate whether it makes more sense to buy or more sense to rent. Because people never take into account the proper measures and they either skew it in one way or the other. Now, 1 year ago, I had a conversation with one of our employees, Michelle, that works for me. And she said, Brian, do you think I should buy a home right now? We've been able to save up about $20,000. Do you think I should buy a home? And I said, absolutely, Michelle. I said, do you know why you should buy a home? Because I guarantee you, if you put that $20,000 in your bank, 1 year from now, that $20,000 is not even going to buy you close to what $20,000 today is going to buy you, because the US dollar is losing its value and everything else is going up faster than what that interest is accruing in your bank. Now, nobody explains this the proper way. And you always hear, well, like, oh, buying a real estate is a hedge against inflation. Well, I'm gonna teach each and every one of you individuals that is a renter, or even if you own a home and are looking to try to figure out if buying an investment property is the right way to do, how to truly analyze it. So I want you to follow me directly over here. What you're gonna see is Michelle decided to buy a $575,000 house in Murrieta. She needed 3% to put down, so in total, she had $20,000 to work with. Now, Michelle at the time was renting for $29.50 a month. It's a 5-bedroom house, she's paying $29.50. Her new mortgage payment all in was $31.84. So her rent was $29.50 and now it is $31.84. So yes, she did increase her payment by $200 a month. Now, I know right off the onset you say, wow, that's going up 10%, that's a lot. Just hold your horses, I'm gonna show you why you would do anything to be in Michelle's place right now. Now, what happened is, that mortgage payment of $31.84 a month, it's gonna stay the same. And it's not gonna change next year or the year after. Why? Because the interest rate is fixed. It's not going up. Whereas her rent is going up about 5% per year here in the state of California. So guess what? Her little mortgage payment, that is $31.84, is going to be identical to what her rent payment would have been in 3 years by just using a 4% rent increase. So short-term pain for long-term gain is the difference in buying versus renting. Now, besides all of that, guess what? Michelle's house at $575,000 in Murrieta that she bought last year, guess what it is worth today? Well, Michelle's house, 1 year later, is worth $640,000. And that is conservatively. Technically, the appraiser said she'd get about $665,000. Now, what people don't understand is not only did her house go up in value, but her loan balance went down. So you can see kind of on this chart as I'm gonna pull this up for you. So let's go ahead and look. 1 year from now, or 1 year ago, she bought her house. She put $20,000 down. Even after factoring in, if she was gonna sell that house right now today, after she paid her cost to sell the real estate, after you took into effect her closing costs, she would be up $38,000 at the end of the day. So her 20 grand, she turned it into $38,000. Now, she's obviously not gonna sell her house today. And as this goes up in time, as you can see here, in another year from now, she'll be up 90 grand. One more year, $147,000. And I'm not using this unrealistic appreciation. Now, right here in Riverside County, over the next 2 years at least, we're gonna be seeing about 7% appreciation. If you don't believe me, news just came out and most what they call fringe markets, we saw house prices increase from May to May year over year of somewhere around 18%, okay? I used 7% for future appreciation. We have a significant decreasing supply with an increasing demand due to the number of individuals that are reaching home buying age over the next 4 years with the greatest number that has ever existed in United States history. And this is coming on the heels of underbuilding by 50 to 60% for the last 10 years. So just new houses coming on the market, just in most markets in Southern California, you have 3 first-time home buyers for every single one house that's coming to the market. And that is if those houses actually come to the market because of the extremely high barrier of entry to build right here in California specifically, right? So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna look at something else, because what people forget is, now Michelle, she may have been paying an extra $200 a month for her mortgage, right? Over her rent. But guess what? Her mortgage payment, part of that is her principal repayment on her loan. So even if Michelle in 3 years from now $32,000 worth of her mortgage payments are going to be being used to pay down her loan balance. So in 3 years, so let's say 2 more years from now, when she's gonna sell, she doesn't owe 517 like she did when she took out that loan. No, she owes $485,000. So she has $32,000 over those 3 years, or roughly $10,000 a year of her payments that is being refunded back to her. So whoop-de-doo that Michelle's rent was $200 a month higher for the first year, $100 a month higher for the second year, and then equal. Because guess what? She got a big fat refund by having a large portion of those payments being used to pay down her balance, whereas her rent would have been 100% interest. She doesn't get anything back from that rent. Now, I want to follow you over to something and why I like to explain this and why it's more important now to, if you have money, to invest it in something that is a hedge against inflation. So follow me on this. So let's look at both Michelle's scenarios, okay? So Michelle's scenario number one was she took approximately $20,000 of her money, put 3% down on this new purchase of this property. That $20,000 now, her home value had gone up from the $575,000 she paid for that home, that now is worth $640,000 conservatively, right? So that means $65,000 worth of appreciation. So her 20 grand turned into $65,000 of appreciation, plus, not to mention that, her loan balance is now lower by about $8,000 because of the additional payment. So even though she paid about $3,000 more for the year in rent, about $7,000 positive, because right, she paid her loan balance down by $10,000 now. She may have paid $3,000 more in rent. Guess what? That's another $7,000 in equity because now her loan is lower, right? So plus another $7,000. So Michelle's $20,000 investment turned into a $72,000 gain, right? Because her house went up approximately $65,000. She paid her loan balance down with that additional money that she had. Now, what's gonna happen over here? Now let's say Michelle didn't invest in this house, right? Michelle took that $20,000 and she kept it in the bank. Well, she probably made what, 0.5% interest? But guess what? Her 20 grand no longer now is going to buy her the same amount. Think of it this way, right? Because look, if her house is $640,000 to buy that house now, now that is a total of $65,000 more expensive. Just to be able to buy that house, she has to come up with more money. Why? Because her value of her dollar went down, right? Because she has $20,000 right here. So put it this way, let's say that $20,000 back in a year ago, Coca-Cola was $1 a can, right? So we got $1 a can of Coca-Cola. Well, 1 year later today, Coke is now $1.10 a can. Well, if she would have went ahead and used all $20,000 and bought 20,000 cans of Coca-Cola, she would what? At least have 20,000 cans of Coke. Now today, if she was to take that $20,000 and go to the store and try to buy a can of Coke, she can't buy 20,000 cans of Coke, right? Not even close, right? She lost. She is going to be able to now go ahead and doing that math. She is now buying 18,000 cans of Coke. So when you talk about something being a hedge against inflation, what you do is when you take that money and you invest it into something, one, that asset becomes more expensive in dollars. So by the power of leverage, Michelle was able to utilize her $20,000 savings to control an asset that was $575,000. That asset went up in value, partly one, because of supply and demand and houses appreciated, but two, a lot of it went up in value because the dollar is getting less expensive. It's not buying you as much, right? So she was able with $20,000 to get the full gain of an asset that is over $500,000. Now, if Michelle would have put $100,000 down, would her house have gone up any more in value? No, right? No, not at all. So she was able to control through the power of leverage and the preservation of capital to invest that 20 grand, and now Michelle's net worth is $72,000 more than if she would have not bought that house. She would have been better off if she would have went to the store and bought 20,000 cans of Coca-Cola last year than she would be have just leaving it sitting in her bank account today, right? So think about that. So I hope you understand now how inflation absolutely is eating away at your chance of actually creating wealth today. If you're leaving money in the bank while everything else is going up in value, and not must in value, but really truly up in cost in terms of dollars, and your money's just sitting in the bank account, sitting on the sidelines, 2 years ago you should have bought, last year you should have bought. Are you gonna be sitting in the same place 1 year from now, watching me do another example of somebody in my office that bought this house? Or are you gonna be that example? And if you're ready to be that example, reach out to us. We're happy to walk you through any of those basic questions. You can always drop me a comment below, and I look forward to helping you create family wealth.